All right, hello, and welcome to another coaching session. My name is Nobody. I'm going to be here with, it says Steam on here, we're going to be calling him Coyote. He is going to be playing He is going to be playing as the Persians. His opponent will be Disgruntled playing as the Huns. Coyote, I believe, is 1600 level. Disgruntled's about 1550. All right, so how this coaching session is going to work is I'm just going to be throwing a lot of information at you. If you need me to repeat something or you want me to clarify something, just let me know, and that way I can have a little bit of feedback.
Can I just kind of pause it?
Oh, pause the game? Sure, if you'd like.
How do I pause it?
You press the pause button.
Which one?
There's a pause button on your keyboard.
Which hot button?
It's literally the pause button on your keyboard. There's a button on your keyboard that says pause.
I don't have one, actually.
Oh, I think you can change the hotkeys in options. Let's just continue with the game as it is. And we could just talk while playing the game. That's usually how I do it.
It's too loud.
Oh, it's too loud?
Yeah, for my game volume.
Oh, okay. Let me just message him and it'll pause it.
Thanks.
Okay, go ahead.
Master volume, music volume, just close it. Okay.
Yes.
Okay, he can hit unpause now.
No problem.
All right, so our standard build for Persians, we're gonna start with six on sheep and then four on wood.
Oh, yes.
So, are you familiar with any standard builds?
I guess I'm gonna go as aggressive as possible because it's Huns and I have Persians, so I'm expecting It is like mounted archers. Yes.
What do you think your best feudal rush is as Persians? Skirmishers?
Already? Maybe for the
It's gonna be a scout rush is the standard meta for the Persians.
Yes.
The Persians, they get bloodlines. They also get some good early game economy bonuses, so they can go up early. And their archers are pretty substandard.
Really?
Yes, because they don't get Arbalest or Thumbring or Bracer.
Yes.
So Scout Rush is going to be a best bet. You're going to want to put three villagers onto a lumber camp. This is going to be a messy game.
Oh boy.
Location.
Yeah, boar's fine. That's a tiny detail.
Okay.
We're just gonna focus on the build. We're gonna put three villagers onto this lumber camp. He's good with keeping his town center working, though. Although his build is really weird. I'm in push to talk, by the way.
A wall? It's quite open over here.
Yes, it's very open. Well, actually, your map is not that open compared to most Arabia maps. But it's okay, we're gonna go for a scout rush. That's an early aggressive strategy. It should keep him on his toes.
Okay. I should focus more on food.
No, you need more on wood. You need three on wood.
Okay, I have three already.
You need three on the lumber camp. Yeah. And we were late to get over there in the first place. So let's add another to wood. I'm switching up the build a little.
Okay.
And we can lure a second boar in now.
Sure, it's 20 foot.
Yes, it's a little late. We have plenty of sheep laying around, though.
Yes.
Good. We could fill up our berries. We could put four on berries. And you're gonna need a house pretty soon.
All more day. Ari?
T90 official as well. He's one of the up and comers. Yes?
Everything okay?
Yeah, moderately. You need a house and you want to fill two more on your berries.
Ari?
Keep your town center working at all times.
Ari? All more days.
Bet he's over here.
Yes, let's go find all of his major resources.
Yes. Hero here. I believe I found all my sheep.
Yes, you did.
Oh, deer. Okay.
Don't worry about the deer.
Oh, I found his deers.
Oh, okay. Oh my god, he's luring deer. I'm so impressed.
Almost up.
We can click up to the next age now.
Yes.
Now, the standard population to click up with Persians will be 21 population for a scout rush, but since we've had some idle time on the TC, we're going up on 19.
Yes.
And with all these idle villagers, we can build a second lumber camp. Don't put them on berries.
Salon?
We only want 4 on berries.
I don't have the wood.
You can take some of these straggler trees. By the time they'll get to the wood, you'll have enough wood, trust me.
Okay.
And we only want a maximum of 4 on berries.
Shalom.
4 on berries, okay, too much right now.
Yeah, you can take those off and you can put them on wood.
Where is this guy? I just found his sheep.
Ari?
Make sure your woodcutters are working efficiently.
Yes. Okay.
Yeah, you're doing great. And when you can afford it, you can build a stable with 2 or 3 villagers.
Okay, 2 or 3 villagers, okay.
You found him!
Oh shit.
It's okay.
First, I'll get a, maybe not the double big axe.
No, you need your stable first.
Yes.
And I think those were your sheep. I can't be sure, though. I don't know. Were those your sheep?
It's not mine. It's very far from me. Okay. So, definitely not mine.
It's a little confusing because your build was a little bit wonky.
Yeah, a little bit. What's that? I mean...
Now, you could bring those sheep in towards your town center, and we could actually use those.
I don't have any villagers around here, though.
Yes, but your town center is going to build those villagers.
Yes.
Ari?
And you can afford your economy upgrades. You don't need a spearman right now. He is still in the Dark Age.
Okay. He'll be going for a fast castle, then.
That's not sure. If he's going for a fast castle, let's pressure him. You don't need the second stable. Don't build the second stable. You can't afford it. You need farms.
Yes. Maybe I could get a blacksmith.
No, you need farms first. You're gonna run out of food very quickly.
Yes.
Now go ahead and send those spearmen forward. He's still in the Dark Age. We don't have any use for them.
Oh, he's the,
Go and send those spearmen forward. We don't have any use for them.
Put him here. Up here.
And we have too much wood, we could seed some of our some farms with some of these wood villagers. Good. Keep the town center and stable working. Archer range for disgruntled. What does disgruntled's resources look like?
Hit his gold.
Let's go for fast castle. Yeah, hit his gold.
Okay.
Don't lose any of your scouts, though.
I won't.
That's a good attitude.
Idling.
Keep your stable working.
1 kill.
Good.
Who kill?
Oh, Disgruntled's actually gone up with two archer ranges, not a blacksmith. So he can't go for a fast castle. Keep your town center and stable working. They've been idle for about a minute.
Yes.
We can add that blacksmith now.
Yeah, for sure.
Do you think that's the best position for your blacksmith? It is blocking wood saturation.
Yes, but... I can see him going for archers. I should have my, this one. The armor ready.
Yes.
And also I'm housed.
Yes. Good time for wheelbarrow.
Yes. Go.
Now our goal with Persians is to go straight into knights and just defend with as many scouts as we need. You can start adding villagers to gold. In fact, you can take some of the wood villagers off and add them to gold.
Yes. Where's my gold, Annie? I didn't see it really. Oh, over here.
Thank you, VHStream, for hosting me with 95 viewers. Wow, thank you. We're doing some coaching sessions with Coyote and Disgruntled. And I'm so glad to see you streaming again, VH. It's been such a long time since I've seen you streaming. I'm a huge, huge fanboy of your stream.
Ari?
Keep your town center working, and make sure not to take any of the spearmen hits. Good. Your micro is very good.
Already? Ah, shit.
It's okay. It's okay, you're doing your job. You're just distracting him. I think you're playing a little bit too risky, though.
Yes.
The spearmen are deadly. Make sure you're taking your gold.
I'm taking a... What?
Yeah, they're being stupid.
Ah.
Now, the best thing to do would probably be build a market now and click up. It's gonna take you too long to mine that gold. And his archers are coming for us now. So let's build that market.
Probably need enough.
You probably need to get what?
A archer range.
No, you do not need an archery range. It doesn't play to your civ strength. And you just don't need it.
I have all my full income, so...
What is my rank? My rank is 2k1 on HD. And 1700-ish on Boob League. Although many people would debate that. I'm sorry, what? What did you say?
I just saw all my stones go up.
Yeah, there you go. You're gonna need a lot more on gold for knights. You can take some of these wood villagers off and put them on gold. And as well, you can sell about 200 of your wood.
Okay.
Good, good. Now, as soon as we hit the next stage, I think the best course of action would be to go straight into knights and try to build as many as we can. Bloodlines would be a great upgrade right now. Bloodlines would be a great upgrade. Let me check to make sure he's got the economy upgrades. He has Bidaxe, he's missing Horse Collar. You've missed a big upgrade this game.
Oh, it's a farm upgrade. It's a Horse Collar.
Yes. You want to get that before you seed up your farms in Feudal Age.
I really don't have any,
Hello, King
Gary. Much wood income for now.
Yeah, that's perfectly fine. Let's not worry about it for now.
A little bit
too late. Okay, he's in the castle. He's got good massive archer. Keep your scouts alive at all costs.
Yes. Oh.
As soon as we get these knights out, they should destroy archers. You gotta back down with your scouts. Oh boy. Good, good. Use your market if you need to.
Yes. I can't sell anything, actually.
Oh. Alright, let's wait for the next two nights. Let's see what armor we have. Bloodlines plus one. Alright, this should be enough. Oh, he's building knights himself. I didn't see that coming.
Oh. Oh, still knights.
Yeah, it's okay. Keep those knights coming, use the market if you need to.
Yes.
Good, good, good. Looking good for us so far. We're about 200 points in the score lead. Alright, let's push him back.
I think I lost a wheel.
It's okay. Yes. Oh, that's good, yeah. That's good.
No, I didn't.
Yeah, that's good. Make sure your town center is rally pointed to something. I would rally point it to wood.
Oh, okay, it's wood. At the back. At here. Over here. Okay. Oh, yes.
Salon.
Yeah, I don't know what the university is for. This is gonna be a good raid, though. In fact, this could be a GG raid.
Deep soul.
Oh boy, you're having a field day.
Oh boy.
Now you can afford the plus two armor.
Let's go.
What is that Maybe. Stone? You must have sold the stone. Now keep maxing knights. As soon as you have enough wood, you can get the bow saw upgrade. And keep going out for more and more raids. Hit them from all different angles.
Yes. Up this way, though. Like, he's quite defense from this way.
Well, he also doesn't have a lot of army. Maybe wait till you get the plus two upgrade.
Oh, cool.
Man, those Persian knights, they sure shred through archers. Good, we have tons of army now.
You first. Risky.
Perhaps try a different angle.
Perhaps this way, a wood camp? Not so sure. Castle? Perhaps. Yes.
You can afford the bow saw upgrade now. And you could use some of that extra wood to place a mining camp on your stone, so we can eventually add town centers.
Oh.
Where's that monk? Oh, he's gonna-
What the fuck? Oh, over here, okay.
Now you might as well kill that monk because the monk used its conversion.
Yes. Gonna add some more, maybe...
I wouldn't bother with scouts.
Okay.
You can add a mining camp onto your stone.
Yes. Fuck. Okay, not for now. Monk for now. Get it. Two conversions. Yeah, we're getting a siege workshop.
You can add a mining camp to your stone.
I forgot.
And you can afford a siege workshop as well. Make sure those knights are pumping out.
Forward to here.
What's up, Lying Relic? Nice to see you again.
Also, have a monk.
Yes, you can also add a monk. You're figuring out yourself.
Wait. That's
not a good idea for Disgruntled to go for both armies at this point. It's too expensive. Could get in this wood line.
He's going for Imperial.
Is he? No. That's a good rate. Now, you're seeing a lot of knights now. What's one advantage the Persians have over the Huns as far as cavalry wars?
Their faster production rates.
What's one advantage the Persians have?
A little bit forgot, actually.
It's going to be what?
I forgot a little bit.
Camels! You have camels!
Yeah! Oh shit. Oh, wise.
Oh, bad raid.
Yes.
You can go ahead and buy enough stone for a town center. Yes, this guy's about 1600 HD. And so is Disgruntled. Disgruntled's probably about 1550. You don't have to add that many camels, so you can add just a few. It depends on his archer knight mix.
What is wrong with my ready points?
Oh my god, that was a lot of stone to buy. Oh my god, that's a lot of stone to buy.
Yes.
What was all that stone for? I think you bought a little bit too much stone. You don't have enough wood for a town center. There we go. Some rams. Well, might as well go with the rams now. Okay, we're not. Where'd the wood go? I swear I just saw the wood drop. Okay, fine. Well, somehow Disgruntled's still in this game. He's sorely lacking upgrades, though.
Again.
Make sure you have a dedicated house villager at this stage of the game. And you will need more on gold.
Yes.
This is very risky for
Disgruntled. But you're also low. Okay.
It could pay off, though. I've been stressing adding TCs. Don't worry. Perhaps use some of those camels that are coming out of your stables. You can send a few camels back. And this is where having an extra town center helps. No! Oh boy, this is a lot of. Now you just need to send back the camels. You actually don't need to send back the knights. That's good. Get your economy back working as soon as possible. Good, good, good. Oh my god. Keep your town center working. We need a little bit more food. You might want to feed some more farms.
Yes.
We have three stables, but we can't produce out of three.
Yes.
Many coaches. There's not that many. Oh my god, that's bad.
I mean, just hide this fucking voting kind of the algorithm.
The what?
About a rage right now.
There's me as coach, there's Klaskus.
Not looking good. It's approaching my score.
And there's also AoC coach, but he doesn't coach that much. You have a lot of idols, let's sort them out. And we're currently not taking any gold also.
No, where did I do wrong?
You have five stables and you can't produce out of one stable.
Oh my dear.
We're gonna have to mine some gold.
Oh boy.
Now bring your army back to defend. Or attack with it. You need to do something with it.
Monks are going forward.
You need to do something with your knights.
Yes. Go!
And your camels as well. Oh, it's all going downhill.
Go, monk.
Use your camels as well. You have camels next to your stables. Use your market to keep producing military. You need to take gold. Take all of your wood villagers off and put them on gold.
Yes.
There we go, that's good. That's some good damage. Use your camels next to your stables. That's a nice raid. Yes, I know I am green, I know about all these things. I can't tell them to do everything. Use your camels next to your stables.
Yes.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Can't afford a TC if you've been paying attention, I am green. Look at his resources. You need to get your town center working again. Use your camels.
Where are them?
They're next to your stables.
Oh, shit. I forgot over here.
Yeah, you need to bring your knights back, I think. I'm not angry at all. I have to be so chill for these coaching sessions. Because the shit hits the fan all the time.
You're finished!
And that's what makes these coaching sessions so fun.
Basically.
Let's wait for those knights to come in. Use your market. God damn, this is so messy. You don't have enough to take those crossbows yet.
Okay. How do I build up for those?
He's missing five stone for the town center. There you go. I've never gotten angry with coaching anyway. I think you're thinking of Rhea. Rhea and his angry coaching sessions. Siege workshop will be good. You need to get your con. Bring all of your army back. Do you have any army left? Oh god.
Not ready.
Alright, well, with 100, 100. Nothing to deal with these knights. We have one camel.
What?
I think it might be GG. Well, that was fun. Oh, there's some villagers. Alright, we can go ahead and resign. Alright, where do you think you're at?
His economy is...
It's working! It's working. Ours is not.
No gold income.
Well, actually, we didn't have gold income for about 6 or 7 minutes.
Yeah, but I had a little, villagers still carrying some gold around, so...
Well, having gold around doesn't do us any good if we don't mine it.
Yeah, but I don't know, where did I fall behind?
Well, you had a good advantage with your military early on. I don't think we did as much raiding as we should have. You kind of stood around with your knights, and then as soon as he hit us with that first raid, we weren't able to adequately defend ourselves. Especially with those crossbows and monks put in together.
Yes.
And after that first raid, we weren't able to get our economy back on track. You kept adding stables for some reason, even though we couldn't produce out of more than one stable.
I just don't have the eco to just support that much army military production rate.
But it's a waste of wood if you add the stables in and you can't afford it. It would have been better off to add a town center or to add farms. I did mention earlier on to add a town center, but we didn't.
Yes, but I never really have the wood to accomplish that.
Well, you did at one point, but we didn't add it still.
Sometimes it's maybe too much focusing on the on the army micro, I guess.
Well, if we didn't have the wood, which we did have the wood, we would have had the wood if we didn't go forward with 3 extra stables.
Yeah, of course. So it's Persian against against Hans. So Hans doesn't have so much eco bonuses as much as Persians, because Persians got the work rate bonus, right?
Yeah.
So plus 15% castle. I remember this.
Yeah.
But yes, it's just.
Yeah, but Hans can hold their own.
Also, army composition. Look at. I mean, also like crossbows that he's all left with. And I've eliminated all his monks and knights, I guess.
Yeah. I think that our army composition could have been stronger than his army composition, but it just didn't turn out that way.
I was looking to produce some mongnos or some light caps to all mass his crossbows, but it's too late. Mm-hmm.
So also, what was the siege workshop for?
For his eliminating this expo threat.
Yeah, but you built rams. You built a ram.
Not from here. I was going forward, like from here, cause it's very near to his main goal over here.
Yeah, that's true.
But this, plan just got aborted, and I don't have the army to support this front. Mm-hmm. As well as this, this house wall, this building wall is not so strong as I thought.
Yeah, but that started all the way in Dark Age, the poor walling, I think.
Also, I had a crappy wood line. Look at this pound.
Yeah, it's not the best wood line, but...
It's so discreet.
That's not the biggest deal.
But this guy has only one, like, his gold and main wood line is over here, so...
Well, the thing that saved him were those monk conversions.
Yes. And I lost so many, so many of them due to the roting. I didn't, like, micro the roting so much. Mm-hmm. Pathfinding issue. So, I don't blame on the lag. I mean, this dude is even more laggy than I am.
Uh-huh.
Maybe 200 milliseconds.
Okay. So, do you see, if you look at your map, where the proper places to wall would be?
You mean for, as an opponent to break in my own base, right?
I'm saying, if you were to re-wall your map in the most ideal way, do you see how you would do it?
Here, definitely. This is a critical point. And
I can't see on your screen.
Okay, so it's my near my market and to the westbound wood line.
Yeah.
Here, it's a yeah. definitely a spot. And also from the deer spot, right?
From the deer to the wood line.
Yes, deer to the wood line. And of course, from the back, because this is my main wood line. I must cost all I can get to defend this.
Yeah. We could have done that much earlier in the game with houses.
Yes, here is close with towns to the north.
And then you could have added the barracks there as well, and then the blacksmith. And then just finish it off with a bit of palisade.
I mean, this guy's micro is not by far the best. I could see a lot of idling as well as I do. But it's just the case of competition. I mean, I don't know. I often play as a Hans, but not so much as a Persian myself. Just this gonna go as a wild card for this time.
What do you think of the game, Disgruntled?
The main reason of the failure of the
well, the main what's one thing you could have done better and one thing that you did good?
One thing is my early aggression, I guess.
I'm asking animal. Disgruntled. Yeah.
My economy was better when I reached feudal, and I reached feudal much I think earlier than he does. So my as well as this around the main gold, I really rushed him. I mean, I killed kind of at least 10 wheels at one time.
What about you, Disgruntled? What's one thing you could have done better and one thing you probably didn't do so well?
Definitely defense.
Yeah, he doesn't realize I'm in the channel, mate.
Oh, Disgruntled's in the channel, by the way. I'm asking Disgruntled.
Okay, sorry.
What's one thing you could have done better and one thing you did worse? Disgruntled.
I could have, once that initial feudal, I mean, the Dark Age went pretty terribly for me, but the recovery was probably one thing I could have done worse, i.e. what did I do well? I think I recovered well from that initial feudal attack, because the scouts killed two villages, and then I actually had, for that very small period of time, a window of opportunity to get on the aggressive little at that point, so I probably should have reacted, and micro was pretty terrible at this point. But
I thought your micro was actually pretty good. It was pretty decent, at least, you know, for this level. You know,
and I think my army composition, I just reacted faster than he did. So
there was a few big mistakes. Like, there were two big mistakes that stuck out to me. The first one was, what was your feudal age strategy? Because it looked like you were going to do a fast castle. You had like 800 food and 200 gold.
I was, and I saw him go up.
You can't do a fast castle when your map looks like yours.
Yep.
Not arena.
I felt like I was let off the hook, actually, because when I saw him go up feudal, and I thought, oh, geez, I need to create a feudal army at that point, and I'm behind. With the map I had, with both wood and gold so exposed, I thought, this is the end. And I thought, I'll go into archers, and try and defend, and actually when I saw scouts come as his feudal army, I was relieved. I thought,
well,
oh, thank God.
Well, you shouldn't be, because as the skill levels get higher and higher, you know, you go into a scout rush, get up earlier and earlier, and the one critical thing about your map, if I saw somebody was going to go for a fast castle and I already had map control with a few scouts, all I need to do is forward a single tower, and a single tower can take you off both your gold and your wood line.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, I mean, he just gave me room to breathe and recover, which I was quite, and I was at one point going, I'm going to get on the aggressive here when his attack went terribly, and then when he ran knights just at the monks I'd already created, I realized, well, I couldn't, I was still too weak at that point because I was so fragile at the front, I needed to stay and defend for a while longer, so I was surprised I hung in there, and actually when he called GG, I felt like the game was starting to swing my way, but I didn't realize maybe just how much, you know, his villagers had just tanked it up at home. Those crossbows, I'm glad I ended up going with them, because I went with archers to begin with, and then I thought, I'm going to go back to knights, and then change my mind. So if I'd just gone harder into crossbows, I probably could have helped myself out as well.
Yeah. So that first big mistake by you was all those resources you had banked up, and like, you didn't really have a definitive feudal age strategy. Just pick a feudal age strategy. You could do a drush into archers, or a scout rush.
That was
either of those would be great.
Problem, wasn't it? I mean, but, that was, if you had to drill it down to one root cause, it was just no real strategy, no design, no build. Yeah.
Well, with your map, I would probably go with the scout rush. I think the scout rush from the Huns can definitely hold its own against the Persian scout rush. So I would have just done that, and then maybe transition into archers, maybe not. It depends how the game goes. So that's the first big thing, is have a definitive feel late strategy, go up nice and early, and don't have all those resources sitting around. The second thing is, if you're going to go for a castle age army, just pick an army. Don't go with crossbows, monks, and knights. Just go with monks and knights, or monks and crossbows, because it's really, really expensive to, you know, make both of these gold units at the same time and afford all their upgrades and whatever. Plus one crossbows against Persians is pretty useless. I mean, to be honest. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. On paper, absolutely. And I must admit, I'm not really, other than knowing Persians is a cavalry sieve, I wouldn't really know. They just ended up against being, when he went so heavy into camels, they ended up being the go-to unit.
Yeah. But if you're going into archers, just stick to archers. Try not to lose them. Add some spearmen, add some monks, and try not to lose your crossbow mass. And then maybe later on switch to knights. It's really hard to make two units at the same time when you go for a fast castle.
Yeah, right. Would you have gone, when you see those camels coming, would you have...
It's all about monks.
Cavarch?
No, it's all about monks.
Okay.
Yeah, camels can do okay against cavalry archers. No, it's all about the monks when you're in a cavalry war against a camel sieve. And eventually pikemen, but pikemen will hurt your economy a lot.
Yeah, okay.
You know. So that was my big thing for the game. Do you have time to play another one?
Yeah.
Coyote, will you have enough time to play another game?
So that's gonna be, okay. I'm on the other side, right? So, I guess it's okay for now.
Yeah.
Not so much, yeah, Rush.
So, I do owe you some more sessions since I, of course, stood you up that time. If you'd like to play another session, I'm available the rest of the week, or I'll be available next week, and just message me on Steam, or when are you available, Coyote?
Of course, thank you. Nobody. I saw one of your playing with the with this CN something, like that player.
CN Burns, yes.
Yes, I mean your micro was so impressive.
Thank you.
yes, and I've always been watching all the top tier players as the Viper. I mean, this is a long time habit. I mean, hobby of mine, playing this, and I've grabbed the new DLC as well. So I don't know. I just hope that I can grab more experience as I can.
Yeah, it's about the whole game though. It's about the whole game, not just the micro. In fact, the part I enjoy most about Age of Empires is not even the micro or the macro. It's going to be the strategy making.
And the army composition, right?
Army composition, strategy, how you use your civ bonuses to your advantage, how you use your map. That's my favorite part.
Yeah.
Which is partially why I love doing coaching so much. But anyway, message me on Steam, and we can have a next coaching session pretty soon if you're interested.
So is this session also recorded on Twitch, also maybe on YouTube as well?
Oh yeah, this will be on YouTube for sure. I can upload it, or you can just check the video upload on Twitch. That'll be instant.
Okay.
So go to videos on Twitch under my page.
And your page is also naming Nobody, right?
Nobody 41.
41, of course.
Mm-hmm.
Till the next week.
Yeah, see you next week. Bye-bye. So let's start another game, Disgruntled. That was a very good play from you. I thought your micro was actually pretty good.
Oh, yeah. Really? Because, I mean, he was
it's all relative. It's all relative, but...
running around where they shouldn't have been. But.
Disgruntled, it's all relative, but for a 1600 level, you know, that was micro of a 1700 level, I suppose.
Okay. Well, thank you.